And Modern is pretty huge.
Big weekend.
The state of Modern has been, I mean, what hasn't been said, thought about, written about, read about with the state of Modern now? Yes, Modern is in, you know, from many perspectives, quite dire straits with the Eldrazi menace.
Yeah, it's a little bit ridiculous, actually. You know, people, you know, there were obviously a lot of people who were overreacting and saying, you know, everything needs to be banned. Emergency ban. Because there's going to be this crazy weekend, three Modern GPs.
Ringing the bell for the emergency ban.
Yeah, you have GP Detroit, yeah. GP Melbourne, and GP Bologna,
yeah,
I'm going to say.
Yeah.
And they're all going to be Modern, and people are like, you need to ban something before this GP because, you know, this Eldrazi deck is just way too good. Then you had, of course, the other camp. People are like, look, this is Modern. There's a ton of cards. People will figure out how to beat it. Now that the dust has been settled and you've seen a lot of results over the various opens, I think it's pretty clear that Eldrazi, something needs to happen.
I'm not convinced yet.
This is something where regularly you're looking at top 32s of these tournaments. You have 20 Eldrazi decks in the top 32. That is ridiculous for Modern, that where we were making these arguments before when we were, you know,
how diverse
you are. Yeah, how diverse was. Never expect a deck to be over 10% of the field. That's not going to be the case for these GPs. There's definitely going to be more than 10% Eldrazi decks represented.
How
at
many of these GPs is Eldrazi going to win?
Okay, I think a better question is how many copies of Eldrazi decks are going to make the top 8 out of those 3 tournaments? And I would not be surprised if it's just 10 Eldrazi decks at least.
So you're setting the line at 10.5.
That is pretty high.
You're saying the line
is like 40%.
10.5 Eldrazi decks in the top 8 out of 24.
All right, 8. I'll set the line
8.5. 8.5 Eldrazi decks.
So like a third.
Oh, no, wait. You're saying the line's at 7.5 or 8.5?
You know what? I'll give you 8.5.
8.5.
You gonna take the under on that one?
God, that's tough. That's tough. I mean, it's great. It's amazing.
I think what's gonna happen is day one, you're just gonna have a lot of people playing a bunch of different decks, and then all the smart people who play Eldrazi. Or ways to the Eldrazi decks that beat Eldrazi decks are gonna all the cream rise to the top. Day two, you're gonna have a much denser, just denser amount of Eldrazi decks, and then all the Eldrazi decks are just gonna keep going to the top. Now there might be a deck that crushes Eldrazi, but I haven't really seen it yet.
So 8.5. So
that can still like
you're
hang
taking
with all
over
the
8.5. So you're saying an average of 3 Eldrazi deck in the top 8 of all 3 tournaments.
Yes.
It's really hard, Burglar. What do you think on that? You take the over as well?
And that is not a good place for Modern to be.
I'm really debating because it's like one of those things where, do I think there'll be 3 across the board? I don't. But could I get totally walloped and have like 5 in one top 8 and then like none in another? I don't know. I think Modern is a robust enough environment that there are answers to the Eldrazi. Too big an environment for that not to exist.
The problem is, yes, you can get these draws, but just on average, right? If the Eldrazi, because sometimes the Eldrazi deck does mulligan a lot because you don't really function unless you draw one of your 8 cheaty lands or your ancient tombs, right? Sometimes you draw multiple Iavugans and that's also bad. But just on average, I mean, if you just have a bunch of people playing the deck, it just has a 60% win rate or something like that. Mm-hmm. It's ridiculous. You know, you just shouldn't have a deck that just wins that off, because anytime you just draw 2 of the Eldrazi lands, you almost just feel like you can't lose.
Yeah.
That shouldn't be the case, because you can build these decks that, all right, I got all these removal spells that are good against killing the Eldrazi cards, and I have some of these 3 drops that are okay. What if your opponent just plays a turn 2 Thoughtknots here? It happens. And then, whatever plans you've had, you just, you know, gets derailed they just go turn 1 Eldrazi Mimic, turn 2 Thoughtknots here, turn 3 Reality Smasher, or whatever, you know, a Drowner sometimes. It just gets to play these gigantic creatures at such a discounted rate on a fairly consistent basis that it's just really hard for a lot of decks to compete.
How's the Lantern matchup?
There are cards that are very good against Eldrazi.
Yeah.
And Stirring Bridge is one of them.
Yeah.
So,
but I mean, how is that matchup? I mean, that deck's incredibly difficult to play, and I don't think it's necessarily a successful GP deck, so I would hate to put my hopes for Modern and Lantern Control.
Well, you know, right now, Modern's at a place where I think the clear 1 and 2 is Affinity and Eldrazi. Mm-hmm. And, you know, that's kind of the risk you take when you play Lantern, because, you know, the fallout from people packing a bunch of Affinity hate You know, you're going to suffer from that as well. So people are going to play their Stony Silences and Creeping Corrosions and Shatterstorms, Ancient Grudges. Mm-hmm. And, you know, if you're going to be playing at a Modern GP this weekend, you got to make sure you have a plan for both of those decks.
I agree with
or
that.
Just play one of those two
yeah,
decks.
Yeah, I agree with that. Okay, I'll take the under just because it's not interesting if I don't take the under.
Right.
So I'll take the under on 8.5. I mean, I do think that... Do we even figure out if Grafted Skullcap was in the format?
Mashi's trying to brew a deck with Grafted Skullcap and its Snaring Bridge.
Yeah. So I don't think it is. And Avaricious Dragon is such a bad fit for that deck.
Right.
7th edition. Ah! Oh,
yeah.
Urza's Block in 7th edition, is that right? Come on, Wizards of the Coast, throw me a freaking bone.
I'm just saying that, like, you know, sometimes you get these affinity starts that just seem unfair and you're playing a different format, right? Because you get to play with Mox Opal, which allows you to generate an extra mana. Mm. This deck has 8 lands that do that, right? So you're just, when you draw these lands, it just feels like you're playing a different format. Feels like you're no longer playing Modern.
No, I agree with that. I've seen it play out, and it's insane. Like Mimic is insane. Yeah. And in fact, Channel Fireball President and CEO John Sasso says that's like he thinks that's the card that should get banned.
No, the deck would be fine without Mimic. I mean, the Mimic
is
good.
It would be fine, but he thinks it would slow it down enough that it's
no.
It's
you need to ban fine. One of the lands.
You think so?
You have to ban one of the lands. I think in order to make like the deck might still be viable, it would slow down. You'd have to play Expedition Maps maybe to try to find the Eye of Ugin or the Temples, one or the other.
Yeah.
And it would be a playable deck still, I think, but not like absurd the way it is right now. You get to play 8 Ancient Tombs. That's just not reasonable in Modern.
No, I agree. It's insane, yeah. But I just. I guess I have a little more. I have faith in the format that the format will correct.
They've had almost a month to correct, and it hasn't happened. You know what's happened? People are now playing blue-white Eldrazi because it's the Eldrazi deck that has the best matchup against all the other Eldrazi decks, right?
Right.
You get to play Eldrazi Displacer, you know, which is great. It just, you know, you get to play this creature that just kills endless ones for free, and along with that, you get to, you know, generate extra tokens off the Drowners and Eldrazi Skyspawner. So it's crazy. You know, people are just trying to like. The face-to-face Channel Fireball deck, nobody plays that deck anymore. You know why? It's got a horrible mirror match.
Right.
You don't want to be playing Simeon Spirit Guides and Chalice of the Void's main deck when you're expecting to play an Eldrazi deck 1 out of every 4 matches.
Matt, bring Burn back in. No more Chalices?
Yes. That's the thing. Eldrazi crushes Burn because it can't beat a Thought Knot Seer. It cannot attack through a Reality Smasher. It's actually insane. Just those creatures by themselves are generally big enough that Burn has a tough time attacking through
them. Ensnaring Burn, dude.
Ensnaring Burn?
I'm doing all the work for you here.
Oh, right.
Ensnaring Bridge with Burn.
Grafted Skullcap, Ensnaring Bridge.
Well, you can't play Grafted Skullcap, Paul. It's not in the format.
Oh, my bad.
I can only do so much here, man. I can only do so much.
All right.
Just burn behind an Ensnaring Bridge. Just play an Ensnaring Bridge, play out your hand, burn them. Win the race. I don't know. I'm not paying attention to the format.
Yeah. Maybe. I mean, Ensnaring Bridge is certainly a very, very good card against them. Worship is also a card that some people have tried. So, I mean, there are cards that are decent, but once again, you have all these like 3 and 4 mana cards. Sometimes they just take it with the turn 2 Thought Knot.
It's just too long. Yeah. They can't. You can't worship. You can normally stabilize if you have that in play on turn 3.
Right.
But it's a tough. And the Eldrazi menace is real. This will be the real test for it.
Right.
This weekend is going to determine whether or not there's a banning. I think. If the format can rebound, if it is robust enough, and in fact, the rise of the Eldrazi is more of a new format as opposed to an unhealthy format, will be fine. If it turns out that the Eldrazi menace is too much for the format to handle, I think, we will see bannings in our future. Yeah. So
we'll see. I mean, exciting. I mean, there's 3 Grand Prix this weekend, so a lot of coverage.
Yeah, I was going to say, and a lot of variants and a lot of metagame for us to watch. So this will be a really, really good test for the health of the format.
Just a ton of matches, yeah.
Yeah. It's really, really good because there's going to be so many reps with Eldrazi. For those of you who love Eldrazi, obviously, this could be your last opportunity to play it at the professional level. If it is that degenerate, I think we will see an end to the Eldrazi in Modern.
Yeah, I mean, just think about it. Like, Modern's been around forever. There have been a bunch of nice, viable decks. Then look at the Pro Tour. You know, 6 Eldrazi decks in the top 8. I mean, that just doesn't happen.
It doesn't. Yeah. But that's also a new format, a fresh format, not one that's developed or evolved at all. So that's why my great hope is that hopefully, with time and with access to a massive card pool,
you know what? Just unban Splinter Twin, and then you just have a more diverse format. Bam. I mean, I'm actually not joking.
Would you really play Splinter Twin instead of Eldrazi?
I think Splinter Twin is one of the decks that would have a decent matchup against Eldrazi. I'm not saying that it crushes it, but it would just make it so that people might think
it's
50, twice.
50-50 at best, right?
I think the Splinter Twin is the side you want to be on, but it's closer. Yeah. Remand is a hell of a card. You know, they would obviously tune their decks to play four copies of Cavern of Souls. Uh-huh. So like, yeah, like there's like back and forth there.
Right, right.
But I mean, the thing is, I don't think the a lot of times the Eldrazi deck won't have a fast enough clock because you can just tap down their creatures. Mm-hmm. If you tap down a Reality Smasher, you don't have to discard a card. Just tap down a Reality Smasher, and they don't have too many ways to stop you from just putting a Splinter Twin on your guy.
Yeah.
So.
It'll be interesting, though, if nothing else, if this weekend shows that the Eldrazi are under control, it'll be kind of awkward because this guy's been falling ever since the Pro Tour, right?
Yeah.
No, it has been. I mean, right. This guy literally in Modern has been falling, you know, since the Pro Tour.
Right.
So, come on, guys. Show the world that we can beat the Eldrazi. We can build decks to beat the Eldrazi. I beseech you.
People have been trying, for sure. Yeah. The problem is, you need to be able to beat these Eldrazi, but also be able to beat all
beat
the
everything
decks.
Else in the field, and that's a challenge. Yeah. I agree, especially when you don't have Pillage and Graphite Skullcap. So you know, if right. Wizards, if Pillage. Wizards would
you
give
know,
us
you know,
the
Pillage
tools,
doesn't kill the Eldrazi.
It does kill Eye of Ugin.
Yeah, I suppose.
It does kill Eldrazi Temple.
Yeah.
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 Yeah, yeah, kills a lot of things, Paul. Maybe you should think about it before you start talking about what
I mean,
Pillage can
Blood
and
Moon.
Can't do.
Blood Moon is a good card against Eldrazi. Once again, you need to play it quickly.
Yeah.
Because you play turn 3 Blood Moon on the draw, it's actually pretty bad. It doesn't do anything. You know,
yeah,
you need like to play a turn 1 Birds of Paradise, turn 2 Blood Moon, or like a Simeon Spirit Guide into Blood Moon.
Also, Pillage pretty versatile against Affinity. I'm just putting it out there, man.
Pillage is way too slow against Affinity.
Wizards of the Coast is scared of Pillage, man. Scared of Pillage. I understand it though. I'd be scared too. I'd be scared too. So, all right, that's our Magic TV for the week. Hopefully, we get some really really cool innovations coming out of this Modern weekend coming up. That leaves us with this week's topic.